Hey guys, so I'm now ready to talk about Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes. How is it? In a word, amazing. I really like it. I think this game just, you know, even though I've watched the 10-minute intro cutscene already before I bought this game, because that's what they teased Ground Zero with, that's what the trailer was, pretty much, just the introductory cutscene. I've seen it before, but seeing it on my TV, actually, like, experiencing it from the beginning, it's pretty amazing. Like, it's still Kojima, the way he does his cutscenes, pretty amazing. The gameplay itself, this is, and I'm pretty sure if you followed any games media, IGN, Game Trailers, GameSpot, they've all said this. This is the most fluid Snake has ever been, you know, the way you control him. And it's really true. It's the most fluid, very kind of streamlined. Everything is just streamlined. It's like kind of, it's Peace Walker, but a step a little more. It's way more intuitive. You get behind covers automatically, and you can pop, you can shoot from the cover automatically. And there's so many options too, like tweaks to, you can disable the slow motion thing, you can disable the track and marking thing, you can disable, enable many different things. And it's just an amazing experience, I think. And it's a very, like, suitable for, like, open kind of the area that you're set in Metal Gear Solid 5. Because you're in this Camp Omega, which is a black site in Cuba. And it's this area where, like, there's a bunch of tents, a bunch of towers. It's a very simple area, I think. The graphics, Fox Engine, I think, fits really well into this setting, but it's not like a complicated art environment. You know, it's not like Killzone 3, for example, where there are so many little particle effects and so many, like, design building structures. It's very simple. It's very clean and crisp graphics. I think that's what Fox Engine does. It's very shiny. So, it looks amazing. I mean, I think the graphics are particularly really great, and one thing I really like about Metal Gear Solid graphics has always been the facial animations, and that still holds up really well. Big Boss looks freaking amazing. So, the game looks amazing. It plays well. It's not an easy game. This is not an easy stealth game, like, because no longer are enemies, like, you know, there isn't, like, a percentage camo index anymore. That's gone. You know, Metal Gear Solid 3 had that, Metal Gear Solid 4 had that. That is gone. It's all about kind of blending into the environment and making sure that the enemies are far away. Enemies that are really far away still won't see you. But once they can start, like, they can see you from really far away. So it's pretty difficult. Like, when I first started the game, I was having a really difficult time, like, getting anywhere, getting used to this kind of this whole new stealth environment. And it's pretty damn fun, though, once I got used to it, you know. The aiming of the gun is super hard. You know, there is bullet drop, but it's just really difficult for me to get a handle on it. It's still a struggle. But that makes it, like, that makes stealth so worth it. You know, because it's so difficult for gunplay. But CQC is streamlined now. You can just go up to people and just take them down easily. So if you want to play it, like, in a way where you don't care about getting caught or getting an alert status, you could definitely play it that way. It opens up a lot of playstyles, this game. It's the most kind of flexible Metal Gear Solid game in existence. Most easily accessible, I think, even though it's such a difficult game. And, yeah, one thing that really kind of doesn't feel like Metal Gear in this gameplay experience is you're outdoors all the time. In fact, being indoors, like inside a structure in this game, is very claustrophobic, and it's really hard to... just really hard. It's a very uncomfortable experience being indoors in this game. It's kind of ironic, considering that Metal Gear Solid, the first game, was pretty much all indoors. Kind of. Like, that's not really true. But, like, the indoor stealth, like, running around inside a structure, inside rooms, that's pretty much been the hallmark of Metal Gear Solid experience. Metal Gear Solid 2, you were inside the tanker, you were inside the big shell, a lot. There's a lot of indoor experience. And I think Metal Gear Solid 3, we start to kind of see this trend where the indoors is kind of uncomfortable, but there's still a good portion of it. Metal Gear Solid 4 is probably the one where being indoors is the most uncomfortable. And I think that's with the camera. You know, when you have a top-down camera, being indoors is much more comfortable. When you have a 3D rotational camera, being in the outdoor environment is probably much more easier to do. But it's because also the enemy vision. They can see so freaking far. If you play in hard mode, and you can... I also don't like the decision that I have to unlock hard mode. Never like that. Like, that should be open from the very beginning. You know, but you have to play normal mode first on all the missions, and then you can unlock hard mode. But hard mode is ridiculous. They can see from so far away. And that's part of the challenge of it. And the slow motion gimmicky thingy, it really doesn't help when the enemies can see that. When the enemies discover you from that far away, and you do the slow motion where you have to aim your shots, and in one shot with the tranquilizer, I haven't really used any other weapons other than the tranquilizer. But the other weapons too, it's really hard to aim. Gunplay is really difficult, and that's intentional in this game to encourage stealth play. And I love stealth. So overall, I think this is a really awesome experience, but it does end really too quickly. It's over before like I know it. And I mean, that's not to say there's a lot of things to be able to do. You can kind of, there are vehicles to operate, which is kind of awkward in a way. And when I'm in a vehicle and I'm driving around, it's really not stealthy. Like, I can get discovered too easily, so I don't really like to use vehicles all that much. But yeah, overall, I really, really like the experience overall, and the graphics are pretty amazing. And I don't know, there's just a lot of things about it. It's just like, I want more of this. You know, it does end quite too quickly. The Camp Omega is big, but it can be explored in about an hour and a half. Like I said, I spent about 7 hours in this game, but that's because I replayed Ground Zero's campaign like 3 times, and I replayed many of the other missions many times. There's so many ways to play this game that I found really interesting. Here are a couple of things I didn't like about Metal Gear Solid Ground Zeroes. A couple of things I didn't like. In the beginning of the game, you can't really kind of set up your loadout, like what weapons you'll have. It is procurement on site, which is kind of annoying all the time, having to find weapons. But like, I think after beating the game, you should get an option to be like, I want to start with this weapon, or I want to start with this weapon. So that was annoying. The unlocks, the rewards that you unlock are not that interesting. Like, you get to unlock a time trial, or how fast you can mark and track all the enemies, or, you know, like, I don't see, whatever, like, that's not why I want to replay the game. There was another thing. Oh, carrying prisoners around. So, really cool, like, how quickly Snake moves in this game. If you put Snake on sprint, he is like Usain Bolt, like he's super fast, and he could carry people on his back and just like run. So when you get an alert status, you can just run like the lightning, and enemy guards will not be able to chase you. It's pretty amazing. But in Peace Walker, you had the Fullerton system, where you can kind of go up to a guard, stick this parachute on him, and away he goes, and he's recruited. In Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes, there is no Fullerton. You have to individually carry every single prisoner to the rendezvous helicopter point. And that's kind of annoying. Also really annoying is, whenever you call the helicopter, no matter how stealthily you call it down, afterwards, the enemies are like, everyone, focus your gunfire on the helicopter. Like, they know of it. Like, that's, I think that's pretty dumb. And also dumb is when you rendezvous at the helicopter at the very edge of the shore, where nobody is there, all that helicopter has to do is go to the shore. But no, it flies into the base and out that way and receives all this gunfire for no reason whatsoever. That, I think, is also pretty dumb. But I mean, I get the point, though. I guess the point is to show the Fox engine. You know, oh, look at the amazing graphics of all these structures from far away and distant. But yeah, those are kind of my criticisms of the game. It is ridiculously hard in some moments, So, you know, in some ways, I think that's what makes this game challenging and fun. In some ways, that's what makes this game really, really frustrating. I haven't been able to S rank any of the missions, so don't know what that's about, because I've been able to do no kill, no alerts. I've just been getting A ranks with that. Maybe it's the amount of time, or well, I'm also penalized for retries, so that's part of it too. I've been like, I will get discovered, and I'll be like, okay, restart from checkpoint, and yeah, the checkpoint, the save system. Also, I don't know why modern games do this now, but you only get one save, like that's it. I hate that. I want to be able to like make a save here, start another mission. I was like, oh, you know what? I want to kind of go back to this mission and just have multiple saves. Ground Zeroes is like so many other modern games like it that it only has one save slot, and it saves automatically. You can't choose when to save, and it saves on checkpoints. Some of these checkpoints can be very far apart. I hate that. That's less player choice. I do not like the fact that this is an open world game with just one save. That's what Metal Gear Solid 5 is going to be like. And I really hope Phantom Pain doesn't have that. You know, it lets you save on multiple slots at least. At least three slots or something. It's just one save slot. It's just not cool. But I don't know. I feel like what I've seen from Ground Zero is just probably going to be what I get from Phantom Pain, but just on a map, on a more massive scale and with more story. So next video, I want to talk about the story. And I'm not going to be, I don't think I'm going to be as positive as I was on the gameplay. I think Metal Gear Solid 5 gameplay, I want more of it. I'm really excited for Phantom Pain. Really, really excited. I had so much fun with Ground Zeroes, and I was very impressed with it. But yeah, next video, let's talk about the story.